Get ready to match the stars. Dick Martin. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. From Lakes, Laurie Mahaffey. Richard Dawson. And Joyce Dulafont. As we play the star-studded big money match game 78. And now, here's the star of match game 78, Gene Rayburn.
All right, John, are they okay? Yeah. Are you okay?
It's a splendid jacket.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you very much.
That's kind of you to notice, yes.
Oh,
would you like to feel the material?
I don't know where to start.
I'll give you a clue, but later in my dressing room. Let's say hello to Donna Blodgett and Tina Richardson. How are you? Current champ is Donna with $100. She had a little bit of difficulty with the audience match, didn't she? And we met Tina Richardson yesterday just as we were leaving the air. We found out she collects figurines of hippopotami, and she likes to water ski. And she lives in Laguna.
Laguna Hills.
Laguna Hills.
Uh-huh.
Now, that's inland from the beach,
right, exactly.
Isn't it?
Uh-huh.
Well, that's near Vic Braden's, isn't it? No, I guess it can't be. I don't know. All right, here we are. Whoops, there. Oh, we got to do a commercial. Oh, you want to do a commercial? Yeah, I was going to try and push this button, but it doesn't work unless you do the commercial. See that? The whole thing is interconnected. One big electronic computer. The commercial goes first, then the button will work. See? I'll stand here until you come back. Get off me!
Buzzer presents Family Feud Huddle Talk.
How it works now? Makes a funny sound? Now make it come up again. Make it come up. Now make it go down. Oh, I have to push the button. Oh, yes, of course. I make it go down, he makes it come up. That's the way it is. All right.
The doctor says it's time for your bath.
Oh, yeah.
Just get on with it.
Here, you want A or B?
I'll take B, please.
B it is. All right. At the beach, Fred said. I don't know how some women get into those bikinis. I mean, why, it's like trying to put ballet slippers on a blank.
You're going to have to come over here. Fred said that?
Fred said at the beach, he says, I don't know how the ladies get into some of those bikinis. I mean, it's like trying to put ballet slippers on a blank. Tina Richardson. Tina. At the beach, Fred said, I don't know how some women get into those bikinis. I mean, it's like trying to put ballet slippers on a...
The only thing I can think of is hippopotamus.
Hippopotamus. Well, I would hope that some of the people here remember that you collected hippopotamus figurines.
I almost said that because she has some kind of hang-up there.
Yes, she does, right.
But I said elephant.
Elephant is close to hippopotamus, yes.
Well, I thought about all those people and animals and all like that, and I said elephant.
You said elephant, yes, with the fanny flag spelling.
There was a ballet of hippopotamuses, wasn't there, in Fantasia?
There was indeed, in a Walt Disney film,
so yeah. I chose truck driver.
Okay. So we have two elephants and a truck driver. It's getting interesting. The
I
company
like truck driver.
You like truck
yes,
drivers?
Much
yes.
Better.
What have you got there? One elephant. No hippopotamus so far, Tina. Show your hippopotamus.
I wish I had. I had an elephant.
Elephant there. That would really be the traditional answer now, wouldn't it? There, wouldn't it, Joyce? You know what's going to happen? The weirdo's going to say hippopotamus.
Takes one to know one.
Hippo! Okay, Donna. She matched one celebrity. Let's see how you do. The bionic man said, when I go out with a bionic woman, I can't keep my hands off her. That's because she has a magnetic blank.
When I go with a bionic woman, I can't keep my hands because she has a magnetic.
That's right. When I go out with a bionic woman, I can't keep my hands off her. That's because she has a magnetic blank. Brum job bum. Brum brum. All right, Donna.
Almost.
Are you ready? Bionic man said, when I go out with a bionic woman, I can't keep my hands off her. That's because she has a magnetic blank.
Magnetic chest?
A magnetic chest. Okay. She said a magnetic chest is what she said.
Well, I don't know if boobs is a...
Yeah. That's in the vicinity. It's close enough.
Close enough.
Close enough there.
I guess I was thrown off by And so I said, with the whole thing, I said she had a magnetic bod.
A magnetic bod.
You know, from tip to toe,
right. Magnetic,
top to bottom.
Total
anywhere.
Magnetic field, yes.
Right.
Chuck, what's a truck driver say?
Bust.
Bust, okay. All right. Cuba Donna Blodgett. Lori Mahaffey.
Yes.
That's because she has a magnetic...
Well, I didn't think you could say boobs, so I said... Chest.
Chest.
Yeah.
Say boobs.
Boobs.
She said it.
I'm sorry, Mother.
You can say it.
You just can't show it.
I'm sorry, Mother.
You're sorry, Mother. Doesn't your mother know you have them? Somebody should tell her mother that...
I haven't seen her for a while.
Oh, you haven't? Oh, I see. Okay, Richard.
This is for your mom. Boob.
Yes, right. You got something for Laurie's mom?
I don't...
Close enough.
I don't understand my answer.
Well, no
maybe
one understood
you
your last one, but it's good. Yes, maybe I can.
It's all I could think of having to do. I sort of understand.
That's because she has a magnetic
field.
A magnetic field is a very scientific term. That's right.
Yes.
The whole body would be magnetic.
A magnetic field.
A magnetic field is something that surrounds a magnet, you see.
True.
Didn't you remember
I knew
school?
I heard it someplace.
Yeah, of course. Well, where are we here? At the end of round 1-4-1 the score. Favor the champ. Now we've got this for you.
When you're looking for answers, it's good to have help.
Find a way. Hello there. Let's go to round 2, shall we? There it goes down again, revealing A and B for Tina.
I'll try B again.
B. Now, Tina, you've matched one celebrity, and that's Joyce. Mm-hmm. And that means you've got to try to do
first.
The others now. Right. Unlucky Louie.
Oh, is he back again?
Is so unlucky. I'm going to tell you, he's the only person in the world who ever got a speeding ticket in his blank. That's how unlucky he is. Excellent. Wonderful.
Cute.
Okay. Tina, Unlucky Louie is so unlucky, he's the only person in the world who ever got a speeding ticket in his blank.
Bicycle.
In his bicycle? Has your brother got the car here to drive you back to East Laguna? In his bicycle.
I don't know. I never sat in a bicycle.
I've sat on a bicycle.
On a bicycle,
yes.
But never in one.
Yes.
I sit in his garage.
There's an answer for you, Tina. He got a speeding ticket in his garage. That's how unlucky he was. Brett?
Well, I didn't go quite that far. I said he got a speeding ticket in his own driveway.
Driveway or garage were the two good ones. You must match the remaining four to stay in the game. You were wonderful.
I don't know why I wrote this, but I just felt it was right for some strange reason. I said bathtub.
Bathtub. And that means Donna wins another game. What the rest of you? Garage, yeah. Come on down. Well, let's say goodbye to Tina Richardson. It was a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
We'll send some gifts from you from Match Games 78. Thank you,
Tina
Richardson. And there she goes. All right. Now, Donna, we've got another shot out of here. Here comes the super match there. There's our big star wheel where you might double your money. Let's begin. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Combination blank. If you match the answer they wrote most frequently, you get $500. And if you match their second most popular answer, you get $250, then $100 for matching the third most popular. And let's see which stars you want to call on now.
Richard?
Combination of the safe.
Safe. Yeah. Combination safe.
Joyce?
Uh-huh. That's the one I liked, Richard's. Combination dance.
Did she say yours? Is it all right
I did.
If she
Can
said
I
yours?
Say yours again?
Yes.
Okay, combination to the same. No, that's not fair, is it?
No, you can't do that.
Combination dance step? Does that make sense?
No.
No, okay. Listen to that one. We forget that one. Combination of...
She's just thinking aloud. Come on.
That's right. Combination of algebra?
Plate.
Combination plate is a common expression in cafeterias, I guess, isn't it?
Brett?
Combination salad.
Salad. Okay, so you got salad, plate, and safe. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own, Donna.
Combination safe.
Safe is what she wants. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. We'll begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Combination plate is an answer that they gave you. May we see the $250 number? Salad.
I don't believe
it. That's right. They're both up there. All right, last chance. Here we go. That's twice in a row you've done this.
I had it, Uncle Gene. Honest to God.
All right. Donnie, you're going to meet another competitor now, so let's all welcome Frank Matro. Hello, Frank. What's wrong, Jake? All right. Frank, we welcome you, sir.
Thank you.
Donna is having a little difficulty here as she gets to the audience match, but she's won two games, and we'll see how you do in a moment or so. Right now, we'll find out a little bit about you.
Well, I'm in pharmaceutical sales in Ventura County.
Yeah.
I jog to keep in shape, and I am kind of a frustrated tennis player.
Really? Aren't we all?
Yes.
Yeah, what's your problem?
Well, it's one of these things where when I first started playing, I improved for about 3 months, and for the last 3 years, I've just
gone downhill.
Plateaued. Yeah. Yes, going downhill.
Do you keep your eye on the ball?
Sometimes.
Do you keep your wrist rigid?
Sometimes.
Do you bend your knees?
Do you bend your knees?
There's
too much. Topspin comes from bending your knees. See, I can do it all here in slow motion, but then when I get in the court, it's all nothing. Okay, Frank, we're both in the same boat. We'll start this game right after we do a little business with America.
Doctor says he's ready again for you.
All right, let's go see the doctor. Hello, doctor.
Let's play the feud.
Prizes are first. From Kenny Shoes, the great American shoe store, an up-to-the-minute selection of fashion footwear, Kenny Shoes not only fit your feet, they fit your life. And long-lasting Ace interior latex paints, plus great equipment from the Painting Place, your helpful Ace hardware store's complete paint department. And jewelry from Sarah Coventry, who has jewelry with fashion know-how for every occasion. Versatile, fashionable Sarah Coventry jewelry sold at home fashion shows. And Hires Root Beer, after 100 years, America's original root beer, is still number one. Hires, the great American root beer. Back to the matches and our star, Gene Rayburn.
Okay, John, here we go. First round coming up here. Ask Frank to make a selection.
B, please.
All right. Ready? You are ready. The lawyer said to Phil,
"Your deceased uncle was a strange man, so before I can read you his will, you're going to have to put on blank."
Something. I really hate to say this, and it's the honest, delivered truth that I heard you. I think I've gone.
Your deceased uncle was a strange man, so before I can read you his will, you're going to have to put on blank. Okay, Frank. The lawyer said to Phil, "Your deceased uncle was a strange man, so before I can read you his will, you're going to have to put on blank."
Earmuffs.
Earmuffs. I must point out to you in all candor, you are more strange than the deceased. All right, what do you say? He said earmuffs.
Ah, well, I say that the whole group of them were strange.
Yeah.
And he said he'd have to put on clothes.
Put on clothes.
They were all sitting there.
Oh, he showed up at the lawyer's office naked.
Showed
huh?
To where my mind is.
Yes. All right.
I
said he'd have to put on a nice dress with a Bertha collar.
Uh-huh. Okay, deceased uncle.
Oh, there's someone out there who I'm just crazy about.
One person
about.
Understood that, yes.
Rubbers and a raincoat.
Okay. Right.
Yes. You're not going to ask me why?
Why is he going to put on rubbers and a raincoat, Charles?
I don't know.
Well, it was a foggy day in London town. Hello, Laurie.
Hello.
Before I can read you as well, you're going to have to put on...
Pajamas.
Pajamas. All right. That's strange.
I know it.
Well, how strange was he?
Put a dress on.
Put a dress on. That would be strange. Well, now we've come to the right person if we want strange, I'll tell you that.
Do I have to take this?
Yes, you do.
This is the strangest thing, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
This is a very straight answer this time.
Right.
This is what I would ask of my nephew, that he would have to put on a Superman suit.
A Superman suit. That would be strange. Okay, see how strange it is, Frank? Now, Donna, we've got one of equal strangeness for you. Did you hear?
No.
Wait till you hear. This mad scientist crossed a camel with a stripper. Now...
Like a girl.
Yes, a girl stripper, yes. Now he's got the only camel in the world with blank. See, crossed a camel with a stripper. Now he's got the only camel in the world with...
Oh, okay.
Have you been thinking about it, Donna? All right, I'll read it to you one more time slowly. This mad scientist crossed a camel with a stripper. Now he's got the only camel in the world with...
Striptease?
Only camel in the world with a striptease. See, what we were thinking of here, see, if you crossed a camel with a stripper, and then you might end up with a camel that would possess some of the accoutrements or physical attributes of a stripper, as you will find out with Dick Martin's answer. He was the first one finished because I suspect he has seen a stripper or two.
With pasties.
Pasties! You know what pasties are.
Right.
What are they? Yes.
I said pasties on his humps.
Pasties. Oh, that's right. Yeah. He was a dromedary.
I started to say
one
two humps
pasty
on his
each.
Pasties, but yes. I realized that didn't make sense, so I quickly crossed that out.
Well, that would be, there's some logic to that, because the pasties go on.
Well, I'll take my glasses off.
Right.
I said two sequin boobs where the pumps
used to be. You didn't understand that, did you? All right, Laurie.
I'm way off. I said pneumonia. Oh, that's funny.
Pneumonia?
I get that.
That's very funny.
That's a hip
funny.
Inside answer. Yeah, because she's naked, you know, and the camel
naked
then was naked
camel.
And he was cold, yes.
Made perfect sense to me.
It would be interesting. The scientist crossed camel with a stripper. Now he's got the only camel in the world with...
Fans.
Some strippers, you know, they do the dance with the fans, or at least one famous one did, yes?
I've got the best answer.
You have?
The only logical one.
What?
I mean, because if you cross those two things, they don't come out with fans and sequins and pasties.
Well,
that's put on later. Because
right.
I'm a very sensible person.
Four humps.
Hi, very funny. That's right. Her two, and the camel's two. That makes four there. Okay. Now we go to round two. Frank, again, you got a choice of A or B.
Let me try B again.
B again? This is it.
B again?
Bill said, this T-shirt craze is really wild. I just saw a girl with a basket of fruit on her front. She had the biggest blanks I ever saw. T-shirt craze.
Bill said...
I just saw a girl with a basket of fruit on her front. You know, the T-shirt. And basket. She had the biggest blanks I ever saw.
Fruit is the operative word. Fruit. true.
Paging Dr. Simpson.
Bill said this T-shirt craze is really wild. I just saw a girl with a basket of fruit on her front. She had the biggest blanks I ever saw.
Watermelons.
Watermelon. Now, Cranshaw will not match, will it? Okay, will honeydews match? Hello there.
How about just plain melons?
Melons. That is a match. Uh-huh. Show us your honeydews.
We won't go. You know what I think? Fanny's been away too long.
Yes, she has.
I said grapefruits.
Oh, yes, indeed.
Been with us, I probably would have thought melons.
What have you got there? Charles, you're adding it up? What are you doing, Charles? Charles.
I'm sorry, I'm into writing music now, and I just saw my first song.
What's it called?
Two sequin boobs where the humps used to be.
I see.
Two empty hearts where the lumps used to be.
Get Tony Bennett on the phone.
Speed it up. Oh, all right. Apples.
Apples?
Apples.
Apples?
My song stunk?
Yes. No, your apple stunk. The song was great. Laurie?
Watermelon.
Watermelon. That's two for you.
Melon.
Melon. That's three for Frank. What do you got there?
The two biggest cherries.
Two cherries. Oh, my goodness gracious. So there you are, three to nothing, and now we've got this for you. Cherry.
Trending.
They are some of the...
Free to join us next time. Match Game 78. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson-Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.
Begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Combination plate is an answer that they gave you. May we see the $250 number? Salad.
Mine are both there.
I don't believe it.
That's right. They're both up there. All right, last chance. Here we go. Lock. That's twice in a row you've done this.
Charles had it. I had it, Uncle Gene.
You
honest to God.
All right, Donnie, you're going to meet another competitor now, so let's all welcome Frank Matro. Hello, Frank. What's wrong, Jake? All right. Frank, we welcome you, sir.
Thank you.
Donna is having a little difficulty here as she gets to the audience match, but she's won two games, and we'll see how you do in a moment or so. Right now, we'll find out a little bit about you.
Well, I'm in pharmaceutical sales in Ventura County.
Yeah.
I jog to keep in shape, and I am kind of a frustrated tennis player.
Really? Aren't we all?
Yes.
Yeah, what's your problem?
Well, it's one of these things where when I first started playing, I improved for about 3 months, and for the last 3 years, I've just...
Gone downhill.
Plateaued, yes, going downhill.
Do you keep your eye on the ball?
Sometimes.
Do you keep your wrist rigid?
Sometimes.
Do you bend your knees?
Do you bend your knees?
Your top spin
comes from bending your knees. See, I can do it all here in slow motion, but then when I get in the court, it's all nothing. Okay, Frank, we're both in the same boat. We'll start this game right after we do a little business with America.
Doctor says he's ready again for you.
All right, let's go see the doctor. Hello, doctor.
Let's play the feud.
Prizes are first. From Kinney Shoes, the great American shoe store, an up-to-the-minute selection of fashion footwear, Kinney Shoes not only fit your feet, they fit your life. And long-lasting Ace interior latex paints plus great equipment from the Painting Place, your helpful Ace hardware store's complete paint department. And jewelry from Sarah Coventry, who has jewelry with fashion know-how for every occasion. Versatile, fashionable Sarah Coventry jewelry sold at home fashion shows. And Heyer's Root Beer, after 100 years, America's original root beer, is still number one. Heyer's, the great American root beer. Back to the matches and our star, Gene Rayburn.
Okay, John, here we go. First round coming up here. Ask Frank to make a selection.
B, please.
All right. Ready? You are ready. The lawyer said to Phil, Your deceased uncle was a strange man, so before I can read you his will, you're going to have to put on blank.
You want to know something? I really hate to say this, and it's the honest, delivered truth. That I heard you... I think I've gone...
Your deceased uncle was a strange man, so before I can read you his will, you're going to have to put on blank. Okay, Frank. The lawyer said to Phil, your deceased uncle was a strange man, so before I can read you his will, you're going to have to put on blank.
Earmuffs.
Earmuffs. I must point out to you in all candor, you are more strange than the deceased. All right, what do you say? He said earmuffs.
Ah, well, I say that the whole group of them were strange.
Yeah.
And he said he'd have
to... For answers. It's good to have help.
Find a way. Hello there. Let's go to round two, shall we? There it goes down again, revealing A and B for Tina.
I'll try B again.
B. Now, Tina, you've matched one celebrity, and that's Joyce. Mm-hmm. And that means you've got to try to do
first.
The others now. Right. Unlucky Louie.
Oh, is he back again?
Is so unlucky. I'm going to tell you, he's the only person in the world who ever got a speeding ticket in his blank. That's how unlucky he is. Excellent. Wonderful.
Cute.
Okay. Tina, unlucky Louie is so unlucky, he's the only person in the world who ever got a speeding ticket in his blank.
Bicycle.
In his bicycle? Has your brother got the car here to drive you back to East Laguna? In his bicycle.
I don't know. I never sat in a bicycle.
I've sat on a bicycle.
On a bicycle, yes. But never in one. Yes. I sit in his garage.
There's an answer for you, Tina. He got a speeding ticket in his garage. That's how unlucky he was. Brett?
Well, I didn't go quite that far. I said he got a speeding ticket in his own driveway.
Driveway or garage were the two good ones. You must match the remaining four to stay in the game. You were wonderful.
I don't know why I wrote this, but I just felt it was right for some strange reason. I said bathtub.
Bathtub. And that means Donna wins another game. What the rest of you? Garage, yeah.
Thank you.
Send some gifts from you from Match Games 78. Thank you,
Tina Richardson.
And there she goes. All right. Now, Donna, we've got another shot out of here. Here comes the super match there. There's our big star wheel where you might double your money. Let's begin. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Combination blank. If you match the answer they wrote most frequently, you get $500. And if you match their second most popular answer, you get $250, then $100 for matching the third most popular. And let's see which stars you want to call on now.
Richard?
Combination of the safe.
Safe. Yeah. Combination safe.
Joyce?
Uh-huh. That's the one I liked, Richard's. Combination dance.
Did she say yours? Is it all right?
I did.
If she
Can
said
I
yours?
Say yours again?
Yes.
Okay. Combination to the same. No, that's not fair, is it?
No, you can't do that.
Combination dance step. Does that make sense?
No.
No. Okay. Listen to that one. We forget that one. Combination of.
She's just thinking aloud. Come on.
That's right. Combination of algebra.
Plate.
Combination plate is a common expression in cafeterias, I guess, isn't it?
Brett.
Combination salad.
Salad. Okay, so you got salad, plate, and safe. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own, Donna.
Combination safe.
Safe is what she wants. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. We'll be.
Get ready to match the stars. Dick Martin. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. From Lakes, Laurie Mahaffey. Richard Dawson. And Joyce Dillavant. as we play the star-studded big money match game 78. And now, here's the star of match game 78, Gene Rayburn.
All right, John. Are you okay?
Yeah.
Are you okay?
It's a splendid jacket.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you very much. That's kind of you to notice, yes. Oh, would you like to feel the material?
I don't know where to start.
I'll give you a clue, but later in my dressing room. Let's say hello to Donna Blodgett and Tina Richardson.
How are you? Current champ is Donna with $100.
She had a little bit of difficulty with the audience match, didn't she? And we met Tina Richardson yesterday just as we were leaving the air. We found out she collects figurines of hippopotami, and she likes to water ski. And she lives in Laguna.
Laguna Hills. Uh-huh.
Now, that's inland from the beach,
right, exactly.
Isn't it?
Uh-huh.
Well, that's near Vic Braden's, so isn't it? No, I guess it can't be. I don't know. All right, here we are. Whoops, there. Oh, we got to do a commercial. Oh, you want to do a commercial? Yeah, I was going to try and push this button, but it doesn't work unless you do the commercial. See that? The whole thing is interconnected. One big electronic computer. The commercial goes first, then the button will work. I'll stand here until you come back. Get off me!
Buzzer presents Family Feud Huddle Talk.
How it works now? Makes a funny sound? Now make it come up again. Make it come up. Now make it go down. Oh, I have to push the button. Oh, yes, of course. I make it go down, he makes it come up. That's the way it is. All right.
The doctor says it's time for your bath.
Oh. Yeah.
Just get on with it.
Here, you want A or B?
I'll take B, please.
B it is. All right. At the beach, Fred said. I don't know how some women get into those bikinis. I mean, why, it's like trying to put ballet slippers on a blank.
You're going to have to come over here. Fred said that?
Fred said at the beach, he said, I don't know how the ladies get into some of those bikinis. I mean, it's like trying to put ballet slippers on a blank. Tina Richardson. Tina. At the beach, Fred said, I don't know how some women get into those bikinis. I mean, it's like trying to put ballet slippers on a...
The only thing I can think of is hippopotamus.
Hippopotamus. Well, I would hope that some of the people here remember that you collected hippopotamus figurines.
I almost said that because she has some kind of hang up there.
Yes, she does, right.
But I said elephant.
Elephant is close to hippopotamus, yes.
Well, I thought about all those people and animals and all like that, and I said elephant.
You said elephant, yes, with the fanny flag spelling.
There was a ballet of hippopotamuses, wasn't there, in Fantasia?
There was indeed, in a Walt Disney film,
so yeah. I chose truck driver.
Okay. So we have two elephants and a truck driver. It's getting interesting. The company.
Like truck driver.
You like truck drivers?
Much
yes.
Better.
What have you got there? One elephant. No hippopotamus so far, Tina. Show her your hippopotamus.
I wish I had. I had an elephant.
Elephant there. That would really be the traditional answer now, wouldn't it? There, wouldn't it, Joyce? You know what's going to happen? The weirdo's going to say hippopotamus.
Takes one to know one.
Hippo! Okay, Donna. She matched one celebrity. Let's see how you do. The bionic man said, when I go out with a bionic woman, I can't keep my hands off her. That's because she has a magnetic blank.
When I go with a bionic bionic woman, I can't keep my hands because she has a magnetic.
That's right. When I go out with a bionic woman, I can't keep my hands off her. That's because she has a magnetic blank. All right, Donna.
Almost.
Are you ready? Bionic man said, when I go out with a bionic woman, I can't keep my hands off her. That's because she has a magnetic blank.
Magnetic chest?
A magnetic chest. Okay. She said a magnetic chest is what she said.
Well, I don't know if boobs is a...
Yeah. That's in the vicinity. It's close enough.
Close enough.
Close okay. enough there.
I guess I was thrown off by And so I said, with the whole thing, I said she had a magnetic bod.
A magnetic bod.
You know, from tip to
right,
toe,
right. Magnetic,
top to bottom,
total
anywhere.
Magnetic field, yes.
Right.
Chuck, what's a truck driver say?
Bust.
Bust, okay. All right. Cooper Donna Blodgett. Lori Mahaffey.
Yes.
That's because she has a magnetic...
Well, I didn't think you could say boobs, so I said... Chest.
Chest.
Yeah.
Say boobs.
Boobs.
She said it.
I'm sorry, Mother.
You can say it.
You just can't show it.
I'm sorry, Mother.
You're sorry, Mother. Doesn't your mother know you have them? Somebody should tell her mother that...
I haven't seen her for a while.
Oh, you haven't? Oh, I see. Okay, Richard.
This is for your mom. Boob.
Yes, right. You got something for Laurie's mom?
I don't...
close enough.
I don't understand my answer.
Well, no
maybe
one understood
you
your last one,
out.
But it's good. Yes, maybe I can.
It's all I could think of having to do. I sort of understand.
That's because
it.
She has a magnetic
field.
Field. A magnetic field is a very scientific
body
term.
Would,
that's right.
Yes.
The whole body would be magnetic.
A magnetic field.
A magnetic field is something that surrounds a magnet, you see.
True.
Didn't you remember
I knew
school?
I heard it someplace.
Yeah, of course. Well, where are we here? At the end of round 1-4-1 the score. Favor the champ. Now we've got this for you.
When you're looking
for... Put on clothes.
Put on clothes.
They were all sitting there.
Oh,
the
he showed up at the lawyer's office naked.
Showed
huh?
you where my mind is.
Yes. All right.
I said he'd have to put on a nice dress with a Bertha collar.
Uh-huh. Okay, deceased uncle.
Oh, there's someone out there who I'm just crazy
One person
about.
Understood that, yes.
Rubbers and a raincoat.
Okay. Right.
Yes. You're not going to ask me why?
Why is he going to put on rubbers and a raincoat, Charles?
I don't know.
Well, it was a foggy day in London town. Hello, Laurie.
Hello.
Before I can read you as well, you're going to have to put on...
Pajamas.
Pajamas. All right. That's strange.
I know.
Well, how strange was he?
Put a dress on.
Put a dress on. That would be strange. Well, now, we've come to the right person if we want strange, I'll tell you that.
Do I have to take this?
Yes, you do.
This is the strangest thing, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
This is a very straight answer this time.
Right.
This is what I would ask of my nephew, that he would have to put on a Superman suit.
A Superman suit. That would be strange. Okay, see how strange it is, Frank? Now, Donna, we've got one of equal strangeness for you. Did you hear?
No.
Well, you hear. This mad scientist crossed a camel with a stripper. Now...
Lucky girl.
Yes, a girl stripper, yes. Now he's got the only camel in the world with blank. See, he crossed a camel with a stripper. Now he's got the only camel in the world with...
Oh, okay.
Have you been thinking about it, Donna? All right, I'll read it to you one more time slowly. This mad scientist crossed a camel with a stripper. Now he's got the only camel in the world with...
Strip tease?
Only camel in the world with a strip tease.
See, what we were thinking of here, see, if you crossed a camel with a stripper, and then you might end up with a camel that would possess some of the accoutrements or physical attributes of a stripper, as you will find out with Dick Martin's answer. He was the first one finished because I suspect he has seen a stripper or two.
With pasties.
Pasties! You know what pasties are.
Right.
What are they?
Yes.
I said pasties on his humps.
Pasties. Oh, that's right. Yeah. He was a dromedary.
I started to say one two pasty humps on his each. Pasties, but yes. I realized that didn't make sense, so I quickly crossed that out.
Well, that would be, there's some logic to that, because the pasties
I'll take
go
my
on.
My glasses off.
Right.
I said two sequin boobs where the
humps
used
to
be.
You didn't understand that, did you? All right, Laurie.
I'm way off. I said pneumonia.
Oh, that's funny.
Pneumonia?
I get that.
That's very
combination salad.
Salad. Okay, so you got salad, plate, and safe. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own, Donna.
Combination safe.
Safe is what she wants. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. We'll begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Combination plate is an answer that they gave you. May we see the $250 number? Salad.
I don't believe it.
That's right. They're both up there. All right, last chance. Here we go. Lock. That's twice in a row you've done this.
Charles Davis. I had it, Uncle Gene.
You
honest
have
to God.
All right. Donnie, you're going to meet another competitor now, so let's all welcome Frank Mattrall. Hello, Frank. What's wrong, Jake? All right. Frank, we welcome you, sir.
Thank you.
Donna is having a little difficulty here as she gets to the audience match, but she's won two games, and we'll see how you do in a moment or so. Right now, we'll find out a little bit about you.
Well, I'm in pharmaceutical sales in Ventura County.
Yeah.
I jog to keep in shape, and I am kind of a frustrated tennis player.
Really? Aren't we all?
Yes.
Yeah, what's your problem?
Well, it's one of these things where when I first started playing, I improved for about 3 months, and for the last 3 years, I've just
gone downhill.
Plateaued. Yes, going downhill.
Do you keep your eye on the ball?
Sometimes.
Do you keep your wrist rigid?
Sometimes.
Do you bend your knees?
Just, see, there's
too
much.
Spin comes from bending your knees. See, I can do it all here in slow motion, but then when I get in the court, it's all nothing. Okay, Frank, we're both in the same boat. We'll start this game right after we do a little business with America.
Doctor says he's ready again for you.
All right, let's go see the doctor. Hello, doctor.
Let's play the feud.
Prizes are first. From Kenny Shoes, the great American shoe store, an up-to-the-minute selection of fashion footwear, Kenny Shoes not only fit your feet, they fit your life. And long-lasting Ace interior latex paints, plus great equipment from the Painting Place, your helpful Ace hardware store's complete paint department. And jewelry from Sarah Coventry, who has jewelry with fashion know-how for every occasion. Versatile, fashionable Sarah Coventry jewelry sold at home fashion shows. And Hires Root Beer, after 100 years, America's original root beer, is still number one. Hires, the great American root beer. Back to the matches, and our star, Gene Rayburn.
Okay, John, here we go. First round coming up here. Ask Frank to make a selection.
B, please.
All right. Ready? You are ready. The lawyer said to Phil.
Dick Martin. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Riley. From Lakes, Laurie Mahaffey. Richard Dawson. And Joyce Dulevant. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78.
All right, John. Are you okay?
Yeah.
Are you okay?
That's a splendid jacket.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. That's kind of you to notice, yes. Oh, would you like to feel the material?
I don't know where to start.
I'll give you a clue, but later in my dressing room. Let's say hello to Donna Blodgett and Tina Richardson. How are you? Current champ is Donna with $100. She had a little bit of difficulty with the audience match, didn't she? And we met Tina Richardson yesterday just as we were leaving the air. We found out she collects figurines of hippopotami, and she likes to water ski. And she lives in Laguna.
Laguna Hills.
Laguna Hills.
Uh-huh.
Now, that's inland from the beach,
right, exactly.
Isn't it?
Uh-huh.
Well, that's near Vic Braden's, isn't it? Isn't? No, I guess it can't be. I don't know. All right, here we are. Whoops, there. Oh, we got to do a commercial. Oh, you want to do a commercial? Yeah, I was going to try and push this button, but it doesn't work unless you do the commercial. See that? The whole thing is interconnected. One big electronic computer. The commercial goes first, then the button will work. See, I'll stand here until you come back. Get off me!
Buzzer presents Family Feud Huddle Talk.
Now.
How it works now? Makes a funny sound? Now make it come up again. Make it come up. Now make it go down. Oh, I have to push the button. Oh, yes, of course. I make it go down, he makes it come up. That's the way it is. All right.
The doctor says it's time for your bath.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Just get on with it.
Here, you want A or B?
I'll take B, please.
B it is. All right. At the beach, Fred said. I don't know how some women get into those bikinis. I mean, why, it's like trying to put ballet slippers on a blank.
You're going to have to come over here. Fred said that?
Fred said at the beach, he says, I don't know how the ladies get into some of those bikinis. Response. Combination plate is an answer that they gave you. May we see the $250 number? Salad. That's right. They're both up there. All right, last chance. Here we go. Wow. That's twice in a row you've done this.
Did you? I had it, Uncle Gene.
You
honest to God.
All right. Donnie, you're going to meet another competitor now, so let's all welcome Frank Mattrall. Hello, Frank. What's wrong, Jake? All right. Frank, we welcome you, sir.
Thank you.
Donna is having a little difficulty here as she gets to the audience match, but she's won two games, and we'll see how you do in a moment or so. Right now, we'll find out a little bit about you.
Well, I'm in pharmaceutical sales in Ventura County.
Yeah.
I jog to keep in shape, and I am kind of a frustrated tennis player.
Really? Aren't we all?
Yes.
Yeah, what's your problem?
Well, it's one of these things where when I first started playing, I improved for about 3 months, and for the last 3 years, I've just
gone downhill.
Plateaued. Yeah. Yes, going downhill.
Do you keep your eye on the ball?
Sometimes.
Do you keep your wrist rigid?
Sometimes.
Do you bend your knees?
Do you bend your knees?
Your topspin
comes from bending your knees. See, I can do it all here in slow motion, but then when I get in the court, it's all nothing. Okay, Frank, we're both in the same boat. We'll start this game right after we do a little business with America.
Doctor says he's ready again for you.
All right, let's go see the doctor. Hello, doctor.
Let's play the feud.
Prizes are first. From Kenny Shoes, the great American shoe store, an up-to-the-minute selection of fashion footwear, Kenny Shoes not only fit your feet, they fit your life. And long-lasting Ace interior latex paints plus great equipment from the Painting Place, your helpful Ace hardware store's complete paint department. And jewelry from Sarah Coventry, who has jewelry with fashion know-how for every occasion. Versatile, fashionable Sarah Coventry jewelry sold at home fashion shows. And Hires Root Beer, after 100 years, America's original root beer, is still number one. Hires, the great American root beer. Back to the matches and our star, Gene Rayburn.
Okay, John, here we go. First round coming up here. Ask Frank to make a selection.
B, please.
All right. Ready?
You are ready. The lawyer said to Phil, your deceased uncle was a strange man, so before I can read you his will, you're going to have to put on blank.
You want to know something? I really hate to say this, and it's the honest, delivered truth.
Are you okay?
That's a splendid jacket.
Oh, is
thank
that
you.
You?
Thank like you very that. Much. That's kind of you to notice, yes. Oh, would you like gorgeous. To feel the material?
I don't know where to start.
I'll give you a clue, but later in my dressing room. Let's say hello to Donna Blodgett and Tina Richardson. How are you? Current champ is Donna with $100. She had a little bit of difficulty with the audience match, didn't she? And we met Tina Richardson yesterday just as we were leaving the air. We found out she collects figurines of hippopotami, and she likes to water ski. And she lives in Laguna.
Laguna Hills.
Laguna Hills.
Uh-huh.
Now, that's inland from the beach,
right, exactly.
isn't it?
Uh-huh.
Well, that's near Vic Braden's, isn't it? Isn't no, I guess it
I
can't
don't know.
Be. I don't know. All right, here we are. Whoops, there. Oh, we got to do a commercial. Oh, you want to do a commercial? Yeah, I was going to try and push this button, but it doesn't work unless you do the commercial. See that? The whole thing is interconnected. One big electronic computer. The commercial goes first, then the button will work. See, I'll stand here until you come back.
Buzzer presents Family Feud Huddle Talk.
Your call is now.
How it works now? Makes a funny sound? Now make it come up again. Make it come up. Now make it go down. Oh, I have to push the button. Oh, yes, of course. I make it go down, he makes it come up. That's the way it is. All right.
The doctor says it's time for your bath.
Oh.
Just get on with it.
Here you want A or B?
I'll take B, please.
B it is. All right. At the beach, Fred said. I don't know how some women get into those bikinis. I mean, why, it's like trying to put ballet slippers on a blank. Fred said at the beach, he said, I don't know how the ladies get into some of those bikinis. I mean, it's like trying to put ballet slippers on a blank. Tina Richardson. Tina. At the beach, Fred said, I don't know how some women get into those bikinis. I mean, it's like trying to put ballet slippers on a...
The only thing I can think of is hippopotamus.
Hippopotamus. Well, I would hope that some of the people here remember that you collected hippopotamus figurines.
I almost said that because she has some kind of hang-up there.
Yes, she does, right.
But I said elephant.
Elephant is close to hippopotamus, yes.
Well, I thought about...
Oh, a girl with a basket of fruit on her front. She had the biggest blanks I ever saw. T-shirt craze.
Phil said...
I just saw a girl with a basket of fruit on her front. You know, the T-shirt. And yes. Basket. She had the biggest blanks I ever saw.
Fruit is the operative word. Fruit. Fruit.
Paging Dr. Simpson.
Bill said this T-shirt craze is really wild. I just saw a girl with a basket of fruit on her front. She had the biggest blanks I ever saw.
Watermelons.
Watermelons. Now, Cranshaw will not match, will it? Okay, will honeydews match? Hello there.
How about just plain melons?
Melons, that is a match. Uh-huh. Show us your honeydews.
We won't go. Yeah. You know what I think? Fanny's been away too long.
Yes, she has.
I said grapefruits.
Oh, yes, indeed.
If she'd been with us, I probably would have thought melons.
What have you got there? Charles, you're adding it up? What are you doing, Charles? Charles.
I'm sorry, I'm into writing music now, and I just saw my first song.
What's it called?
Two sequin boobs where the humps used to be.
I see.
Two empty hearts where the lumps used to be.
Tony Bennett on the phone.
Speed it up. Oh, all right. Apples.
Apples?
Apples?
My song stunk?
Yes. No, your apple stunk. The song was great. Laurie?
Watermelon.
Watermelon. That's two for you.
Melon.
Melon. That's three for Frank. What do you got there?
The two biggest cherries.
Two cherries. Oh, my goodness. So there you are, three to nothing. And now we've got this for you. Cherry.
Trending.
They are some of them.
Free to join us next time. Match Game 79. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson-Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.
Begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Combination plate is an answer that they gave you. May we see the $250 number? Salad?
Mine are both there. I don't believe it.
That's right. They're both up there. All right, last chance. Here we go. Wow. That's twice in a row you've done this, sir.
I had it, Uncle Gene.
That's in the vicinity. It's close enough.
Close enough.
Close enough there.
I guess I was thrown off by And so I said, with the whole thing, I said she had a magnetic bod.
A magnetic bod.
You know, from tip to
right,
toe,
right.
Top
magnetic,
to bottom.
Total magnetic field, yes.
Right.
Chuck, what's a truck driver say?
Bust.
Bust, okay. All right. Cooper Donna Blodgett. Laurie Mahaffey.
Yes.
That's because she has a magnetic...
Well, I didn't think you could say boobs, so I said chest.
Chest. Yeah. Say boobs.
Boobs.
She said it.
I'm sorry, Mother.
You can say it.
You just can't show it.
I'm sorry, Mother.
You're sorry, Mother. Doesn't your mother know you have them? Somebody should tell her mother that...
I haven't seen her for a while.
Oh, you haven't? Oh, I see. Okay, Richard.
This is for your mom. Boob.
Yes, right. You got something for Laurie's mom?
I don't...
Close enough.
I don't understand my answer.
Well, no
maybe
one understood
you
your last one, but it's good. Yes, maybe I can.
It's all I could think of having to do. I sort of understand.
That's because she has a magnetic...
Field.
Field. A magnetic field is a very scientific term. That's right. The whole body would be magnetic.
A magnetic field.
A magnetic field is something that surrounds a magnet, you see.
True.
You remember
I knew
school?
I heard it someplace.
Yeah, of course. Well, where are we here? At the end of round one, 4-1 the score. Favor the champ. Now we've got this for you.
When you're looking
for... Put on clothes.
Put on clothes.
They were all sitting there.
Oh, he showed up at the lawyer's office naked.
Showed you where my mind is.
Yes. All right.
I said he'd have to put on a nice dress with a Bertha collar.
Uh-huh. Okay, deceased uncle.
Oh, there's someone out there who I'm just crazy
One person
about.
Understood that, yes.
Rubbers and a raincoat.
Okay. Right.
Yes. You're not going to ask me why?
Why is he going to put on rubbers and a raincoat, Charles?
I don't know.
Well, it was a foggy day in London town. Hello, Laurie.
Hello.
Before I can read you as well, you're going to have to put on...
Pajamas.
Pajamas. All right. That's strange.
I know.
Well, how strange was he?
Put a dress on.
Put a dress on. That would be strange. Well, now, we've come to the right person if we want strange, I'll tell you that.
Do I have to take this?
Yes, you do.
This is the strangest thing, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
This is a very straight answer this time.
Right.
This is what I would ask of my nephew, that he would have to put on a Superman suit.
A Superman suit. Before I can read you his will, you're going to have to put on blank.
Earmuffs.
Earmuffs. I must point out to you in all candor, you are more strange than the deceased. All right, what do you say? He said earmuffs.
Ah, well, I say that the whole group of them were strange.
Yeah.
And he said he'd have
to... For answers, it's good to have help.
find a way. Hello there. Let's go to round two, shall we? There it goes down again, revealing A and B for Tina.
I'll try B again.
B. Now, Tina, you've matched one celebrity, and that's Joyce. Mm-hmm. And that means you've got to try to do
first.
The others now. Right. Unlucky Louie.
Oh, is he back again?
Is so unlucky. I'm going to tell you, he's the only person in the world who ever got a speeding ticket in his blank. That's how unlucky he is. Excellent. Wonderful.
Cute.
Okay. Tina, Unlucky Louie is so unlucky, he's the only person in the world who ever got a speeding ticket in his blank.
Bicycle.
In his bicycle? Has your brother got the car here to drive you back to East Laguna? In his bicycle.
I don't know. I never sat in a bicycle.
I've sat on a bicycle.
On a bicycle, yes. But never in one. Yes. I sit in his garage.
There's an answer for you, Tina. He got a speeding ticket in his garage. That's how unlucky he was. Brett?
Well, I didn't go quite that far. I said he got a speeding ticket in his own driveway.
Driveway or garage were the two good ones. You must match the remaining four to stay in the game. You were wonderful.
I don't know why I wrote this, but I just felt it was right for some strange reason. I said bathtub.
Bathtub, and that means Donna wins another game. What the rest of you? Garage, yeah.
Thank you.
Send some gifts from you from Match Games 78. Thank you,
Tina Richardson.
And there she goes. All right. Now, Donna, we've got another shot out of here. Here comes the super match there. There's our big star wheel where you might double your money. Let's begin. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Combination blank. If you match the answer they wrote most frequent. Games 78. Thank you,
Tina
Richardson. And there she goes. All right. Now, Donna, we've got another shot out of here. Here comes the super match there. There's our big star wheel where you might double your money. Let's begin. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Combination blank. If you match the answer they wrote most frequently, you get $500. And if you match their second most popular answer, you get $250, then $100 for matching the third most popular. And let's see which stars you want to call on now.
Richard?
Combination of the safe.
Safe. Yeah. Combination safe.
Joyce?
Uh-huh. That's the one I liked, Richard's. Combination dance.
Did she say yours? Is it all right?
I did.
If she
Can
said
I
yours?
Say yours again?
Yes.
Okay, combination to the same. No, that's not fair, is it?
No, you can't do that.
Combination dance step? Does that make sense?
No.
No, okay. Listen to that one. We forget that one. Combination of.
She's just thinking aloud. Come on.
That's right. Combination plate. Of algebra?
Plate.
Plate.
Combination plate is a common expression in cafeterias, I guess, isn't it?
Brett?
Combination salad.
Salad. Okay, so you got salad, plate, and safe. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own, Donna.
Combination safe.
Safe is what she wants. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. We'll begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Combination plate is an answer that they gave you. May we see the $250 number? Salad.
I don't believe it.
That's right. They're both up there. All right, last chance. Here we go. That's twice in a row you've done this.
Charles said. I had it, Uncle Gene.
You
honest to God.
All right. Donnie, you're going to meet another competitor now, so let's all welcome Frank Mattrall. Hello, Frank. What's wrong, Jake? All right. Frank, we welcome you, sir.
Thank you.
Donna is having a little difficulty here as she gets to the audience match, but she's won two games, and we'll see how you do in a moment or so. Right now, we'll find out a little bit about you.
Well, I'm in pharmaceutical sales in Ventura County.
Yeah.
I jog to keep in shape, and I am kind of a frustrated tennis player.
Really? Aren't we all?
Yes.
Yeah, what's your problem?
Well, it's one of these things where when I first started playing, I improved for about 3 months, and for the last 3 years, I've just
gone downhill.
Plateaued. Yeah. Yes, going downhill.
Do you keep your eye on the ball?
Sometimes.
Do you keep your wrist rigid?
Sometimes.
Do you bend your knees?
Do you bend your knees?
Your top spin
comes from bending your knees. You know what's going to happen? The weirdo is going to say hippopotamus.
Takes one to know one.
Hippo! Okay, Donna, she matched one celebrity. Let's see how you do. The bionic man said, "When I go out with a bionic woman, I can't keep my hands off her. That's because she has a magnetic blank."
When I go with a bionic woman, I can't keep my hands because she has a magnetic...
That's right. When I go out with a bionic woman, I can't keep my hands off her. That's because she has a magnetic blank. All right, Donna.
Almost.
Are you ready? Bionic man said, "When I go out with a bionic woman, I can't keep my hands off her. That's because she has a magnetic blank."
Magnetic chest?
A magnetic chest. Okay. She said a magnetic chest is what she said.
Well, I don't know if boobs is a...
Yeah. That's in the vicinity. It's close enough.
Close enough.
Close enough there.
I guess I was thrown off by And so I said, with the whole thing, I said she had a magnetic bod.
A magnetic bod.
You know, from tip to toe,
right. Magnetic,
top to bottom.
Total
anywhere.
Magnetic field, yes.
Right.
Chuck, what's a truck driver say?
Bust.
Bust, okay. All right. Cuber Donna Blodgett. Lori Mahaffey.
Yes.
That's because she has a magnetic...
Well, I didn't think you could say boobs, so I said... Chest.
Chest.
Yeah.
Say boobs.
Boobs.
She said it.
I'm sorry, Mother.
You can say it.
You just can't show it.
I'm sorry, Mother.
You're sorry, Mother. Doesn't your mother know you have them? Somebody should tell her mother that...
I haven't seen her for a while.
Oh, you haven't? Oh, I see. Okay, Richard.
This is for your mom. Boob.
Yes, right. You got something for Laurie's mom?
I don't...
Close enough.
I don't understand my answer.
Well, no
maybe
one understood
you
your last one, but it's good. Yes, maybe I can.
It's all I could think of having to do. I sort of understand.
That's because she has a magnetic
field.
A magnetic field is a very scientific term. That's right.
Yes.
The whole body would be magnetic.
A magnetic field.
A magnetic field is something that surrounds a magnet, you see.
True.
You remember
I knew
school?
I heard it someplace.
Yeah, of course. Well, where are we here? At the end of round 1-4-1 the score. Favor the champ. Now we've got this for you.
When you're looking for...
Put on clothes.
Put on clothes.